No, no. Well, all I'm saying is that please tell Mr. Balachandran that Mr. Modi mentioned the name of Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee and Mr. Vajpayee alone. That is politicization. It is, I mean, you don't need to be a genius to know that. It is so obvious. I mean, for God's sake, you
when
don't
did he mention it?
When did he mention Vajpayee today?
Today he did not mention Vajpayee.
The name Vajpayee mentioned in today's
speech. No, where did he mention Vajpayee in today's speech? Where did he mention Vajpayee in today's speech, in his congratulatory speech today?
Well,
he congratulates countrymen and scientists.
Well, can I tell you
yes,
something?
Yes, please point out where he said it today.
Consistently he's mentioned it today. Let me tell you, I will give you a speech. I have got it here in front of me. At Sriharikota on June 30th.
What is today's day?
What is it?
Today is the 24th of September.
He's talking about a speech made
What is this?
Ask Sambit Patra to.
I mean, I don't want to call him.
This is
but he seems like everybody is a fool.
To read it out.
He's mentioning a speech that he made somewhere else. I mean, look, this is a pointless discussion that's happening.
Read it out.
No, he's called. No,
he said something then. His father said something then. What is this?
No, you, Dr. Balaji.
Is your talk between civilized people?
What is going on here, Sanjay Jha? I mean, this is 24th of September. He congratulates scientists and countrymen. You should congratulate scientists and countrymen instead of asking. But Dr. Balachandran says all the points that you make are pointless. And he also says today you would not have the guts, Sanjay Jha, to say this at ISRO. And if you were to make this comment at ISRO, Sanjay Jha, he says the scientists would walk out.
It's not about me. It's about the Prime Minister acknowledging the role of various people over the past several decades.
Why do you need to do this?
Role in India's spaceship program that has seen a huge success today. That's the whole point. Ask Mr. Patra. Mr. Patra is sitting there with an eloquent silence. Ask him to read out the full statements. And please, for heaven's sake, Mr. Digvijay Singh is a seasoned Congress leader. He would not tweet that without a reason. Mr. Digvijay Singh has mentioned there that at least an acknowledgement was necessary when you are talking about such a historic day. Please, for God's sake, have the respect of others who contributed equally. It's all he's asked for. Where is Digvijay Singh said something insulting at all? He's only said, let's respect everyone who
has. Yes, he has insulted India today. He has insulted India today when the Prime Minister and the whole of the country was busy congratulating ISRO and Indians. Your Digvijay Singh was busy tweeting that why Nehru's name was not taken there. This is called as height of psychophancy, and I believe Congress lost because of this psychophancy.
Sambit, we know why Prime Minister Modi never mentioned.
So why aren't you understanding? You made a mistake. Don't double it up.
We can do it some other time.
Don't double it up.
That's not the point. We know it.
But why are you doing this? Do you know how people will be reacting to this, Sanjay Jha, across the country? Not just Dr. Balachandran, who's holding his head there in anger tonight as you speak, by the way. You're not seeing Dr. Balachandran there. He's holding his head there.
Oh, I'm not angry.
I'm not angry at all.
I'm amused that these people think they are talking something intelligent.
Arnav, let me tell you, Sanjay Jha is least concerned about Manmohan Singh. It is Sonia Gandhi's name which is under the breath he wants to be out. It is not Manmohan Singh. He's least concerned about Manmohan Singh.
I wholeheartedly
leave you to handle Patra's ridiculous statement.
I wholeheartedly want to say this today.
This is not ridiculous. I know.
Just stop for a minute.
The nation knows it. The nation knows it. You have to bring in the Gandhi family's name somewhere.
Stop it, please. Don't take it on predictable dimensions. We are so proud today. You know, when our country in one shot beats the United States of America. And I can tell you, even the most cynical journalist in me feels so proud. You know, when I got those messages this morning, Sanjay, and I'll read out one of these messages which we got, I felt so absolutely proud, and I myself forwarded it to so many people because, you know, this message this morning warmed our hearts. And the message said, Mangalyaan successfully enters Mars orbit, India leaves USA, Russia behind by making its first attempt successful. It is unbelievable that India spent only 450 crores to accomplish this historic feat and create history in space science. It made us all swell with pride this morning. Swell with pride. And I'm telling you, I did not think...
I think Arnav, Doctor...
Yes, Dr. Balachandran.
Pa- Paranjpe wants to say something.
Yes, Dr. Paranjpe wants to say
something. One man who is actually involved in space program.
Absolutely.
The rest of us are all just talking on TV programs. So why don't you ask him?
Go ahead, Dr. Paranjpe.
What he thinks.
Go ahead, Dr. Paranjpe. Go ahead.
Arnab Goswami, I'll tell you one thing. I was so excited all through the day, but after listening to this particular debate, I'm really saddened. If I was not live on your show, I would have just switched on the television and gone. It was such a wonderful day. All through the day at the planetarium, we celebrated. A lot of people asked wonderful questions. Young children and common citizens were so excited about this event. And then what are we talking about? I'm really saddened. I think that is all I want to say at this point in time.
Absolutely. Sanjay, hear that. Hear that, Sanjay. Don't do it again. You know, you shouldn't do it again.
Take it beyond politics. You're giving a slant to this debate.
What slant?
Because you haven't asked this question of the BJP representative even once, that if India's Prime Minister does not even acknowledge here at this point.
Again, you are going on and on. Please, no, I'm not going to take
several political leaders of the past,
I'm not going to take
including
that.
His political
I'm telling you. Arvind Paranjpe. No. I'm going back to Mr. Paranjpe.
You see, people
Mr. Paranjpe, you made your point, so did I. But has the response of Sanjay Jha changed? No. It's not changed. It's resolute. He's still on the same point, Sanjay Jha. Yes, Mr. Paranjpe. So you see, some things aren't going to change.
Sorry, can you come again?
No, I'm saying, Dr. Paranjpe, you made your point. You expressed your disappointment. I made my point. I talked about how proud I felt this morning. I feel disappointed too that it has to descend to this. But it does. And Sanjay Jha is holding his ground. He's not saying yes, he made a mistake. We're not going to do this again. We won't let the people of this country down. We won't let the young people of this country down. He's repeating his point. You didn't mention Manmohan Singh. You didn't mention Manmohan Singh.
It needs to be taken with gravity.
Now what gravity?
Oh my goodness. I don't know what I'm hearing really speaking.
Let Paranjpe speak
for this country. And we must also...
He has to mention Newton's name if he's going to mention...
And you look at it this way. NASA people congratulate ISRO scientists. They put a beautiful banners which are there on the Facebook. People are collaborating all over the world about this particular mission. And it is not just the India. I mean, India has put the satellite around the orbit of Mars. But there are... it was tracked from three different nations. It's such a wonderful moment. I mean, it's such an exciting thing. And we are talking about very petty thing. I mean, I agree with you completely on this issue.
Yes. Well,
but I really have no words at this point in time, frankly speaking.
Well, you know,
it's a wonderful thing that has happened.
So putting a
small satellite all the way to Mars. The light takes 12 minutes to come to us. It's a great achievement for any country. We should all be clapping for them. We should all be talking about how wonderful this mission was. And if suppose some people think that it was not given credit to them, maybe they can talk about what they have done.
Dr. Paranjpe,
they can talk about what they have done.
Arnav.
Yes, Dr. Balachandran.
No, we can't.
Dr. Balachandran. Mr. Manmohan's character and his integrity, I think he's the last person who would say, why was my name not mentioned? It's all the other people who are talking on either behalf of Mr. Manmohan Singh or the late Mr. Sarabhai or on behalf of the scientists who are supposed to have been mocked. I mean, they're not talking. I'm still puzzled. Has Mr. Manmohan Singh said why my name has not been mentioned?
Not once.
So why is somebody else saying he should have name mentioned?
Because you want to politicize.
Should have been mentioned. Balchan says, what the hell did I do? No, his name should have been mentioned.
Because they want to politicize it. Evidently because the Congress party wants to politicize it. For what other reason?
Arnab.
For what other reason? On other issues, you drop Manmohan Singh like a hot brick. But when it comes to this, you want to use it.
Let the people of India decide.
Let the people of India decide, surely. But let the people of India know, yes, Asifa, I'll come to you. Let them know it's not about the low cost of this project. It's about the fact that it has been done at the first go. And it has been done under many, many odds. I don't think the politicians should even try to come close towards taking credit. I don't think the Prime Minister did, to be fair to him, but I think what followed after that is something the Congress party needs to introspect. Slumdog Millionaire because of you, Abhinav Bindra's gold because of you, a space project because of you. I don't know tomorrow if the monsoons are good, you'll say it's because of the Congress party. Yes, Asifa.
Look, Arnab, what I'm trying to say is, that today when I went across the interviews of various scientists after Modiji's speech, they were all highly motivated, they were so enthusiastic, and one of them reacted that Modiji said that even if this, God forbid, it had been a failure, I would have been here and taken the failure on me. I think nobody is discussing that.
That's right.
The Prime Minister here was there as the Prime Minister
absolutely,
of the country.
Absolutely.
And he was ready to take anything which was the outcome.
Absolutely.
The second important thing which we are missing today is we should be discussing superstition, right? There are a lot of superstition still prevailing, and this is a scientific approach our nation
I agree with you, I take your point, but
these are the things we should be discussing.
Sometimes you have to look at things beyond politics. I'm glad this debate has happened, because I think through what some of the comments that we have made, we put it in perspective. I think it's not clamoring for any credit. The best part is no scientists ever clamored for credit, and many scientists have not got it.
Yeah.
That's what their greatness is. I thank you all for joining me on this debate on the News Hour tonight.